everybody. Cray Spartan here. Now, it has actually been a little while since I have uploaded anything, and I have really, really felt like a slacker lately, and I really don't think that's acceptable. It's just not. I think Big Killa 69, he's got his YouTube channel, and he tweeted to me about them videos, or whatever he said. I can't remember right now off the top of my head, but he called me out on it, and it's like, yeah, I know. I have been such a huge slacker lately, and like I say in here, guys, that's unacceptable. I should not be doing that. I like creating Halo content. It's fun. I enjoy creating YouTube stuff. I really do enjoy it, and I've been slacking, and there's no real excuse that I can give you guys that really explains why. Probably comes down to a couple different factors, honestly, is just the holidays, family, of course, and all that stuff going on. I'm sure you guys had your holidays, the Thanksgiving and everything. Hopefully that went well for you guys. But that's besides the point. And Master Chief Collection is probably part of the its own problem right now. As you guys know, the Master Chief Collection is still very, very glitchy, though it has come. It has come a long way since launch day. It really has. We got more content updates coming soon. I think pretty much 343 has been giving us updates probably at least once a week. So, and the matchmaking experience has been getting better. I mean, it's nowhere near perfect. I cannot say that it is, but it's getting there. It really is. The matchmaking, I've been able to get matches fairly easy, though it does kick me out once in a while. I get to game over screen or whatever else, and it's a little frustrating at the moment. But it is so much better than what it was day one. But I think I wanted to talk about a couple things here on this video, and which is why I'm showing you this. This is the map I have been working on. I am calling it Garrison, and it is not 100% complete. I've only tested it a couple times, but I think it plays fairly well. I've played it with Logan Grimnar, which you're watching right now. Logan Grimnar has got himself another YouTube channel, which I will link down below. And I also tested it once with Mac Attack, or what you might know as Halo Spectrum. He's got his, of course, his Halo channel as well, which I will also link that down below. So I've tested it only a couple times. This map itself, I intended it actually to be more of a 1v1, and I have not tried it with a 2v2 yet, but I want to try it just to see how it works and how it flows. If it works at all, it just might be just a little bit too much. It's a very small map, and I wanted it that way because I wanted to be able to jump online with one friend or whatever, get some warm-up matches in a nice different scene besides, of course, an octagon and all that stuff. And by the way, the octagon maps, just a reminder that they are in my file share. If you want to download those, you can see me online, or you can check out the leaderboards. I have played every single mission on Halo 4. I'm a Halo 4 on heroic mode, so you can check out the leaderboards. You can find me there. It's probably not high up. I haven't looked, but you can check out the leaderboards. Click on my name, Cray Spartan 2, and then you can check out my file share and download those. Now, this map is not currently in my file share. It will be soon. I just want to get some more test runs on it and see how it plays and make a few more changes, but it will be there soon. Now, this is kind of a long video. It is a 1v1, but I did want to finally talk about Halo 5 Guardians. Now, I have been putting this off for quite a while, and I can't really say why. I think it comes down to just how different Halo 5 Guardians is compared to all the past Halo games, including Halo 4. Halo 4 is its own little thing, but Halo 5 Guardians has a lot of new features, which I wanted to discuss a little bit, let you guys know my thoughts on it. First of all, I want to start off with the ADS, or the Aim Down Sight system, that has been presented. Now, that is not a big deal, in my opinion. I don't think it's a huge thing. What it is, I think it's more or less, and this is what everybody I've seen or read about, they're saying it works the exact same thing as zoom function from Halo CE 2 and 3. You zoom in. The only difference is that you have yourself a small animation in front. I mean, you de-scope and everything. So it's just like zoom, except you have an animation. Now, there are some things there that, the sniper rifle, it has the full screen. You don't have the zoom function there, like the animation like you do with the other ones. But that's all right. I can live with ADS, or the smart scope is what they're calling it, version of it. I think it's going to work out well. I'm not going to say it's going to be the best. It might not be. I don't know. Well, I'll have to wait and find out. Get some game time with it. I think that's what I'm really waiting for. Now let's move on to sprint. Halo 5 Guardians obviously has sprint, and I expected it. I really did. I didn't see 343 going away from sprint anytime soon. But my opinion on sprint, I am not a huge fan of it, though. Maybe that's just because of how it was implemented in Halo Reach and Halo 4. Halo Reach, there was pretty much no balancing factor to it. I mean, if you had the gauge up, you could sprint for as long as you had that gauge, and you would slow down, or you would stop once your gauge or your meter ran out. Halo 4, of course, we all know Halo 4 was a little different. It would slow you down if you got shot, and that's not all the best solution either. I always thought if you were going to have sprint, you should at least have like a de-scope function for sprint. Like if you got shot, you weren't able to sprint. But 343 chose a different route. They went with the if you run away and are sprinting, it is directly linked to your shields. And when that happens is you cannot recharge your shields while sprinting. Now, the other thing that a lot of people don't know is when you're sprinting and you stop for like 2 seconds or whatever, however long it takes to start your recharge, if you sprint again before your shields start recharging, it doesn't pause that recharge time. You know, like say if it took 4 seconds to start recharging, it doesn't pause it. Like if you were halfway there and you don't start off at 2 seconds again, it resets the whole recharge time to 4 seconds. So you're going to have to continue to wait. So it really brings the concept of, do I really run or do I sit here and put up a fight? I don't know how it's going to play out overall, but it does look like it will be an interesting factor in the next Halo game. So hopefully it will be a good balance. Now, there are a couple things I am not a particularly big fan of either in this next game, and that is, look at this, bad shots with the sniper there. But the thing I want to talk about is the Spartan talk or the Spartan chatter. If you've seen any other videos online, the Spartans will occasionally call out stuff to you. It's like they'll say, enemy dropped at pink 2 or whatever you want to call it, whatever they killed him at or they spotted him. This is both a good and bad thing, I think. If you're playing by yourself, this is great, I think. Because you can sit there and you can do that and you can hear call-outs from the map or from the other players, especially if they don't have mics, since a lot of people don't play with mics these days. So it has a benefit. However, if you're playing online with friends and you're already doing your own call-outs, this is counterintuitive. This could be confusing and really not helping your team out. So at least I would hope that they are able to turn this feature off, especially for competitive playlists. So well, let's hope on that. The last thing I want to talk about is, and this one I absolutely just don't like, period. I do not like this. And that is the weapons respawning call out from the map. I think this is a huge, huge issue that needs to be removed. But I'm going to enjoy the game regardless, one way or the other. But the reason I don't like this is one of the things that really gave person advantage to their game is if they knew the weapon timers, they knew where they spawned. So that if they always had a power weapon on hand because they took the time to learn it, that was a huge advantage. And it's just taking that extra time and effort on players to do this, just taking that away because the game announces it. But overall, I think I'm going to wrap this up here real quick. It's another one of those things I think should be able to be turned off. But we'll find out in the Halo 5 Guardians beta. Now, overall, though, my last review, I think I want to say I'm looking forward to it. I see it has a great potential. There are some things I don't know about or don't want to really judge until I get some real gameplay on it. But until then, we're going to see what we get on December 29th. And make sure when you do get online and you do play Halo 5 Guardians, hit up the forums. Get on there. And tell those guys what you're thinking and let 343 know what's working, what's not. Well, that's going to wrap this up here, guys. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to give the video a like. This is the Crazed Spartan, and I am out of here.